Today, we come together honoring each other's presence. For we are the presence of God. We are all part of the divine. Through this divine, we are support for one another. We help each other's, meet each other's needs of love and encouragement. We are grateful for this moment and honor it by surrendering to the knowledge that all is provided. And so it is.
So it is. Amen. If this is your first time with us here at Unity of Little Rock, no, make yourself at home. There are drinks and goodies next door. We don't frown in the slightest that you bring that over here and enjoy it over here, because we want you to enjoy yourself. We want yourself to make yourself at home. So feel comfortable. If you want to kick off your shoes, kick off your shoes. Just make yourself at home. If you would like to, Tina in the back has a little card. It just has information about you that you might want to share with us, whatever amount that is. If you'll do that, she'll give you some gifts that have some coupons and some discounts for events and the bookstore here for us. So you get a little gift in return if you'd like to share it with something with us. With that, now I invite you to say hi to your neighbor during our meet and greet.
Is that See that wonderful, colorful expression, you know that that person is our acting prayer chaplain for the day. That doesn't mean there aren't other prayer chaplains in the room who would be happy to assist you, but she is all yes to you today. So step up and do lines. Thank you. I've been reading a bunch, as y'all have heard me complain more than once over the last few months. I had to read a section that actually, as I read it, it had something powerful in it for me. So I'm sharing that with you today, because it was a very just kind of old news story. And the story was about that back in 2008, Starbucks closed 7,100 stores for 3 hours one afternoon. Just closed it up. The chairman had just recently taken back the reins of Starbucks and was also looking at that he didn't quite think he was going the direction they wanted to go, as well as the puppets were going the direction they wanted to go. So he said, we're going to just shut the doors for 3 hours and we're going to work on the basics. Which in this case was, how to pour great shot espresso. So for 3 hours, their emphasis was how to get perfect espresso. I look at that story, they did that in spite of folks complaining, closing their store. Wall Street didn't like it because it might affect profits. There was lots of complaints about that, but it was done because they wanted to be better. That was important. And I would say that since that was in 2008, I think they've done okay since then. Looks like that to me. If not better than okay. In our own lives, here we have Starbucks that dedicates themselves to just having a better shot of espresso. What are we doing in our own lives to just have a better relationship or a better health? Or just simply a better life? Are we committing ourselves to that endeavor of taking some time, some commitment to be better? I think when we look at Starbucks in this case was just showing that sometimes, no matter what else is taking place, you have to come back and find what's relevant. What is meaning to you? In other words, what do you do well and what do you want to continue to perfect, to expand? And for us, I think we all do something well, and that is be the Christ in expression. Because we are it, whether we know it, we like it, we're in it. And I believe we do that beautifully.
Is your mic on?
Yeah. I think it got turned off.
When we're looking at our own lives and what we're doing, what we're committing to me, we're committing to what has value, what has worth, what matters to us. And that's a covenant. And in the Bible, they talk all about covenants in the Bible. From Charles Fillmore's Metaphysical Bible Dictionary, he says a covenant is an agreement. The covenant of the Bible represents the principles by which we are able to gain our true spiritual heritage and possess the riches of the kingdom. To me, that's saying that covenant is what helps us be able to claim and affirm who we are and what we have access to all the time, which is the divine and flow, the Christ consciousness, God, Allah, divine, universal intelligence. What word do you want to use here to identify that which contains and is everything? That we have access to that. That covenant is an agreement in which we're claiming that for ourselves. We may claim it as a people, but most importantly, we're claiming it as for ourselves. Charles and Myrtle Fillmore had a covenant, and I think this is an interesting story. You can't read this because you can't even read it when it's enlarged. It's by Charles. It's a scratch. Charles and Myrtle were the founders of the Unity Movement. They wrote this covenant. They wrote this covenant in 1892. It wasn't discovered in the archives for 50 years before it became really public knowledge within the Unity Movement. I'm saying that because obviously for them, it wasn't a covenant they wrote for marketing or publicity. They wrote it for themselves. And this is what it says. We, Charles Fillmore and Myrtle Fillmore, husband and wife, hereby dedicate ourselves, our time, our money, all we have and all we expect to have to the spirit of truth, and through it to the society of silent unity. In being understood and agreed that the said spirit of truth shall render unto us all equivalent for this dedication, in peace of mind, health of body, wisdom, understanding, love, life, and an abundant supply of all things necessary to meet every want without our making any of these the object of our existence. In the presence of the conscious mind of Jesus Christ, the seventh day of December, 1892. This is a covenant of faith that they're proclaiming what they believe, what they have faith in. And I think that they demonstrated that well in their life. Because most of what we know of Charles and Myrtle happened well after 1892, on what they were writing, what they were sharing, what they were growing into and expanding into. This is a foundation to me that was something that, whether they ever looked at this again in their lives, they still carry that forth. And I bet that they had a way of holding that covenant in writing that followed them through all those years, even though it might not have been this exact example of that. Because that statement of faith is something that we all have. It may not be something we recognize that we have. But you have your own faith. You have what you believe inside of you. How many of you have it written down? Okay? Why not? That's the question. Because it's affirming who you are and what you want. It's affirming your connection with the infinite. That statement of faith is thus then supporting you in where you're going in your life. Andre, do you have something similar to a statement of faith? How are you going today?
I have a number of affirmations that I use as my statement of faith. Primarily, I am a perfect creation of God, designed to do great things.
Exactly. So I picked on him because I know that he's in a program that he is asked to write things down. And that we don't have to have a statement of faith that is beautiful and flowery as Charles and Myrtle's. But we want to have something that proclaims that. So that we're acknowledging it to ourselves. This covenant, this agreement, as I said, is with ourselves. But it carries on. Because what I hold for myself, I take into my life, and it becomes interactive in my world with the people that I interact with. But within the consciousness that I share with all of humanity that I have the blessing of interacting with. Am I the only one? are times a little chaotic and tumultuous, a little angry, a little hay-filled, a little void of peace and kindness and generosity and compassion? Am I happy? Is it just me? I know I'm going to fix that. No. I know that kindness and compassion are not void in our life. It's there. But we sure don't seem to see it when we look at our news, while they're on Twitter and Facebook. I experience a great deal of anger and hatred being shared there. It's my take, my perception. I think it needs peace. I think the people that are writing that want peace and need that peace. And I think we as a culture and we as humanity need peace. I do my best to hold our leaders that everything they're doing is supporting us and for the best interest of us. But I struggle with, are they the ones that are going to lead us to peace? Not just our leaders, but the world leaders. I'm not convinced peace is where their focus is. So if they aren't going to lead us, then who does that?
We do.
We do. And how do we do that? By having the peace within us to access that peace. And where's that peace come from? It comes from that Christ nature, that divine self that's within us. That we're accessing that, developing, expanding, growing that. By all the things that we talk about here on a regular basis, our prayer, our meditation, our silent time, our coming in community, and sharing, voicing, and talking about that, as well as finding the places within us that we struggle and have strived. And how do we get those things out of the way so we can experience what's really there, which is the truth of our being, the beauty of our essence? All of that is important. So we're looking at how do we develop that peace as an individual so that, again, we take that into our world. I don't know if any of us in this room will ever have our genuine 15 minutes of fame. We might all have that 15 minutes. That we get to impact the world in maybe more than 15 minutes. That we touch tens of millions of lives directly, visibly. I don't know if we'll have that. But we're no less important with how we connect day to day with the individuals in our lives. How we share ourselves. How we take that peace that's within us and bring it forward. Or how we take that non-peace within us and show people how we address it so that we find the peace within us. That too is part of that process of us bringing the peace into the world. We have a city that's in need of peace. We have a diversity here that in our culture puts one class of people above another, that puts one color that puts one gender of a people above another. And we may acknowledge and say, that's not correct, and we want to do something about it. And that does require our action to address those directly. But we also, to take that action, want to come from a place of peace. Y'all heard me talk through the years, and Andre and I went to Andrew Harvey's Sacred Activism years ago. And what Andrew talked about was, where's your passion in life? What do you want to make a difference with? Maybe it's animals. Maybe it has to do with race relations. Maybe it just has to do with you want to bring music to kids that aren't getting in school. Whatever that passion might be, the best way you can bring that passion through is not in your anger and your frustration that it's not right in the world, but in that place of peace, that place of being in Christ's nature, and that brings the energy and shape of the divine into this experience of what I want to change. Today, you get the opportunity, like last week, you directly got to write a word on a stone, and that word was, what are you claiming for yourself this year? What's your new name? I'm inviting today, what's your commitment to yourself and to write it? You may not get to write it this morning, and it doesn't have to be simply is to look like you. So you write it like you, what matters to you. And when you have written it, then you acknowledge that there's faith. You have faith that that's who you are and what's being lived out in the world. Now, y'all heard this before. This is out of Matthew in the Bible. It says, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you. This statement doesn't say that if you keep working on that faith, if you build it up big enough, if you heap it up long enough, if you finally get it big enough, you can do something with it. It says the faith of a mustard seed. A pea is massive compared to a mustard seed in size. All you have to do is have that faith, that agreement, that alignment, that commitment with the truth of who you are, and then all things become possible. That mountain is to be by you. And I think it's important to know here that we know mass consciousness shapes us and impacts us, and that just because we believe it, it always means it becomes like our immediate reality. Hold that true faith of a mustard seed. This is saying all that doesn't matter. That mountain doesn't. It doesn't matter whether I believe it moves or not. It matters you. Your faith is what transpires to make this happen in your life and your world. Brother Martin Luther King. There comes a time when people get tired of being pushed out of the glittering sunlight. Life's July, and left standing under the piercing chill of an alpine November. I think we can relate to being out of the chill today. Your covenant, your commitment to your faith, so that agreement, that covenant that you have, is your way of taking you out of the chill of your own life. People do their best to impact us in our world. Sometimes negatively, but we're the ones that decide whether we allow that impact and what we do if we interpret that impact as being done to us. We get the ones that get to decide, do I step out of the chill of this moment into the sunshine, into the light? That's our choice. Doesn't always mean it's easy. Doesn't always mean that we snap out of it in the next 3 seconds. But we have the opportunity to move from that chill of life into the warmth, into the peace that resides there. There's a peace of sitting, of being quiet, of being still, of hearing that small, silent voice within us. And I know that many of us, if not all of us, know that experience. Touching that silence and knowing that silence is not, it's not quiet. There's a whole lot going on in that silence. It may be still and calm, but it's filled. It's expansive and massive. And it's outreach. And it's filled with infinite possibilities. So our ability to connect with to describe it as a small still voice because there is a calmness and peace still that takes place more than that. There's also a peace in which we take action, a peace in which we move into our lives and have motion in that peace. Your covenant that we talked about is your way of claiming what you're taking into the world. Peace that we need in our society isn't only an internal silence. It's emotion reaching out into our world and making a difference. Jeannie Bailey has been a significant part of our family here of helping us reach out into our greater Little Rock community and touch lives. Touch lives within our own direct media community, but to touch lives outside of us. To take that peace, of which in that peace is kindness and generosity, abundance and share that with others. And each and every one of us have the opportunity to do more of that in our lives. That doesn't say you have to sacrifice your life. It opportunity to find ways to do it when the opportunity arises. All of us have that opportunity to do more in certain situations, in certain circumstances. So today, I'm going to invite you, go home, write your own covenant. Put it where you can see it. If you want to share it with someone, share it with someone. Let them know what you're proclaiming about you. They don't have to respond in any way, shape, or form. Just let them hear it if you choose. And then look at it. Where is the peace in my own life? What is my commitment to myself? And how am I taking that into the world? What am I doing today, tomorrow, this week, to bring that forth? That would be visible. Be visible in action. So with that, I invite you. So what? Some of you know that I asked that. So what? So what do you do with what I did today? Do you go home and do something with that, or do you not? You get to choose that. Was something I said today, did it touch you, or was all of it just boring and tedious? It could have been. Then so what? If it were glorious, Boris, easy. Yeah, boring. Boring and tedious. If it were that, then so what? What are you doing with it? It's your choice. You get to live your life. How do you take the experiences of your life and move beyond them in the direction you want to go? So if you didn't like the experience, so what? What are you doing with it in your own lives? So with that I say, and so it is, amen.
Amen.
To the sweetest kind of life. Yeah.
center of the divine consciousness flows into us through our crowns, down through our heads, into our torsos, out our arms, and into the pools, growing, expanding our heart center. Each breath has more. Bring in that beautiful, loving, compassionate, kind, generous light. We can tell with this expansion of love and light, that which is not drifts away, burns away in the light, no longer impacting us, no longer controlling, no longer an adversary in our life. We're connecting the love and light of divine nature. We're connecting peace and joy. Peace is our nature. The light didn't bring it anew. The light is activated. It is already ours. Expanding our awareness. Enticing us to commit more to living to that light and that peace. As I sit in this heart space, bringing my awareness and my attention there, I allow that small, still voice to speak, to bring clarity, to share with me a message, an intention, a desire, a want. As I sit in the silence, I affirm and claim, this is who I am. This is who I am. Had access to. He was always my companion. He was always in me, as me. The message that was conveyed, the thoughts that were held, all of that. peace that you wish to see in the world is the peace you are. Allow this voice to offer insight and direction. Rise and fall of our chest, the awareness of our bodies sitting, where our feet are located, where our hands are placed. As you're ready, you bring your full awareness, full attention, and that small, still voice back into this awareness in this room. Opening your eyes. So it is.
So this year I decided that we were going to do this little thing called Featured Artist of the Month. And for January that is done by the name of Peter Baer, and I believe there's a little biography that was supposed to go on the insert. I didn't grab a hold of it today and see if it was in there.
Not this week.
Not this week. So next week it'll be in there. What I remember though, he's a gentleman from Minneapolis. We have done some of his songs in the past. In fact, our opening song this month, Where is the Light, is one of his. We have done Everything is Holy Now. Was a very good song. And Blue Boat Home is another one of his. And I went up about this week, a woman called Singing a Song.
So give it feeling, give it a ride.
Bring it inside you, make it strong, so that when the trouble comes round to feed you, so that when we sing a song. Eyes will shine, the night is bright. Hearts will hold, the night is tight. When our words only spoken, so give it feeling, give it right. Lay it in for a quarter time. Sing it with a heart while life overtake us, till angels mistake us for a heavenly throng. And may that joyful sound be our shelter, and bind us together, sing a song. We'll be together, sing a song.
Thank you. This is time in our service where we get to receive from you your financial abundance. I want to affirm here, tithing is in some ways part of your own personal commitment to your own covenant, because it's affirming that which aligns with your own statement of faith. And when you contribute here, you're giving your energy in a very tangible way to align with this community that holds and supports the vision and the image that you hold for yourself personally. So you allow us to hold a bigger space to allow more to step in and find a place that aligns with your own spiritual and personal beliefs that support you. This isn't the only place you do. Wherever you give in your world, however you give in your world, I invite you that you want it to be aligned with your own personal statement of faith, so that you're affirming what you hold in faith, but you're also supporting and adding energy. You're contributing to the resonance of that experience, so that it has the opportunity to grow and expand as well. So with that, I invite you to take your gifts in hand, if you give online, a hold, the thought, the intent of that generosity in mind, and join me in affirming together. Together, divine love as me, bless us and multiplies all that I am, all that I give, and all that I receive.
invite you today. And however moves the easiest for you, that you see what's being held here in this offering, what's being given generously in this community, that you see that in your mind's eye, and that you take it down deeper into your heart, that heart we hold in meditation, and see that love, that light, that generosity, that compassion, that kindness, that joy flowing into that experience of money, the experience of volunteerism, the experience of all generosity that takes place in this community. That you're returning that love with love, blessing what is received, but blessing the giver, allowing them to receive of our hearts, receive of our love, receive that we too celebrate their generosity and love them for being who they are. And so it is.
Yeah, now we can do a few announcements. Miss Jeannie. You'll help me? I know I need help. Come on.
No, Ms. Lyman, you need help.
Where's your headset?
You know what? I have been looking for something awesome for January, and I haven't found it yet. I've been a tad bit busy with a newborn, and then there was illness there. So if anybody wants to help me out with some headbands.
It may or may not be relevant to some people. Is this your newborn or...
Yes, as a matter of fact, it is.
You like a little bit of miracles here. So
I think that would be great.
She'll get even with me later.
Not to worry at all. Not to worry at all.
Well,
we
don't
need to
see what you're saying, sir.
Thank you, Jeff.
There's no telling what I will be wearing up here soon. That's right.
Very soon. And it is the second Sunday of the month, which means it's our Celebration Sunday. And this is the time that we celebrate any life events that may have been happening in your life in January, be it birthdays, anniversaries, anything you'd like to share with us that we can hold you in the light with it. Does anybody here like to share anything?
Yes, Tam.
What's that? Oh, Tam had a birthday. You think I didn't remember that? Yes. Amongst everything else going on in our life, Tam decided to have a birthday. Really? Yes, he's a January 1st baby. He was actually the first baby born at the hospital in Ferndale, Michigan, and his parents received free diapers for a year.
Oh, a bunch of stuff. I was born at 3:03 in the afternoon, too. So.
Oh, wow.
Very small time.
Very small time. So yes, sorry, yes, January 1st. Any other January birthdays that we can celebrate?
Anniversaries, great promotions, no other events. Well, my acknowledge here a life event. I know that Bondra, her sister Jeanette has passed this week. So we want to acknowledge that. But also in celebration, we'll celebrate her life and her life with Bondra and Bondra's continuing life of holding and remembering her sister. As well as a great teacher that passed this week. He was the first male in my life. Some of us know that in this teaching there's a lot of females. And I went through an earlier teaching that there were no male teachers but him. And he was the great living example of what it's like to be fully in your heart and be a man and carry that male masculinity into the world as a loving presence. And Murray made his transition this week. And I want to acknowledge him because he was a great teacher and a great love.
Transitions can be a little challenging for those of us who are left in this plane, on this earth.
We know that firsthand, don't
This Friday, we have our acoustic cafe, Sounds of Unity, and we have Laura Lynn and Justin in the house with us. That's January 23rd.
January 23rd, yeah. So come out on Friday night, hear a song, will be in the house with us, and we'll be sharing local songwriting and songwriters and celebrating and getting songs and music and love.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. And then on Saturday, Wind of Wisdom, and I decided, I'm sitting here thinking I need to change the name of WOW to maybe HOW, Hearts of Wisdom, because it's not just the ladies in this phenomenal community, but the guys, the gentlemen that have been supporting us throughout all of our community project outreaches. So I'm thinking of it. I'm not going to ask you your opinion. Anyway, what we're doing, Pamela Duncan, who is back here on our soundboard today, she is going to lead us in making sleeping / sitting mats for the homeless. These are being made out of PLARN, plastic yarn, and it starts with plastic shopping bags. PLARN's weird. I hope you don't get a hold of it. We have had an enormous amount of contributions to our plastic bags, but this is very labor intensive and it's going to be fun. And we need everybody there. Men, women, children, I know I've been asked tonight, can my sons come? Absolutely. Because we have to cut them, we fold them, we then make them into strips, we connect the strips, we take the strips and we roll it into a ball, and then we take that and we start crocheting those into mats. So everyone is needed, and so it's come to my attention that, hey, why just do it Saturday? Let's do it Sunday too. So Sunday after service, Russ will take us all out for lunch. Thank you, Russ. And then we're going to come back at 1, and from 1 to 3, we'll continue. Or maybe he'll bring food in, or maybe he'll do both. He doesn't mind, really. Just give me your credit card, no problem. So it's going to be fun times to have by all. And he needs to have coffee on Saturday too. Oh my gosh, right? But you know what? I'll bring the treat for Saturday, because you're just being so generous. So thank you.
This is the respect.
One more thing, I'd like to talk about our house. Talk about generosity. So last month, right in December, we adopted 2 very needy families through our house. The response was overwhelming. We collected over $600 from this community. We gave 2 families an outstanding Christmas. And so please take time in the back on the community bulletin board for 2 thank you cards from those families. It just has touched me so much. And I hope it has touched you as well to know that everything we do is appreciated by our community out there. So thank you all so much for really touching the lives of our community.
There will be a board meeting after the service next Sunday, for those of you who want to be aware of that. Also, our spirit groups are beginning. Spirit groups are a great place to meet people, so it's a great social experience, but that's not why we have spirit groups. Also, we don't have spirit groups just because you learn some great knowledge. You can grow in your understanding of spiritually important ideas. We do it because it's part of the commitment to yourself to grow in your spiritual awareness. And spirit groups are formed for that, because in relationship is how we actually grow. I, in my wonderful classes that you know, some of you know that I'm taking every week now, I get a great understanding of something, and then I get to go in class, and I get to tell them about it, and then I realize I don't understand about it. Nothing about it, as it comes out of my mouth. And that's why we want to be in groups and in community, is to talk about things that are relevant and important to us, to get clarity about, do we really understand this in our life or not? Or, yes, I do understand it, and I'm passionate about it, but until it came out of my mouth, until I was in a relationship, I didn't recognize it. So our spirit groups are forming. We're going to highlight just this week, 2 of those, and one of them is the Prosperity Plus, which is a Mary Morrissey program, so it's all her prosperity intent to very much address your financial and money life, but anything that has to do with your abundance and prosperity world. I know that Andre's teacher, I believe, trained with Mary Morrison.
Still does.
Yes. As well as that's Laura Lynn. So they can't necessarily tell you about this program, but they can sure tell you about the benefit of having someone that's utilized what will be so much in this program. In the back, sitting next to Tina on the table, is a clipboard. Angel has agreed to be our host, and that will be happening here at Unity. But I want you to put back there your interest in joining the group and what evening might work best for you if you do that. Our other group might be someone that's standing up here.
That would be me. There has been a book that has come into my life, which I become very passionate about. I just love it. It's called The Afterlife of Billy Fingers. And it's a life after death story told to Billy's sister, and it's Annie Kagan who wrote it. It's a great read. I don't know, but Laurelyn, have you read it? You're shaking your head.
I wanted to. Frank told me about it before his death, and I wanted to read
it. It is quite an amazing story. It's a quick read. I know you can find them on Amazon, new and used. So if you'd like to come and join, and it's going to be at my house, so I'm going to do it on Monday nights, and I live in the Alexander area. I'd love to have you come join me.
Thank you. The next thing is important to my heart, and that is because we have an incredible music team. They work hard for us, and that means they put some effort into it. They have made a commitment to us, and Tam has been a crucial, vital part of that as our music director. And my joy is that I have watched him improve his own talent musically through these months that he's been with us. And plus, Ben, we get the benefit, right, of that. So Tim has the, we want to give him the opportunity to go and experience more music, more very positive-oriented music, at the Posey Music Festival that happens in Tampa. That happens every year. And we seldomly have the opportunity to send one somewhat because we don't typically have the surplus revenue to do that. So what I would like for us to do this year is to give Tam the opportunity to go by donating what we need. And that is $1,200 for all the expenses necessary to get him there at the end of February. So I'm just inviting our community to give what you can so that we can get Tam there to have the opportunity to not only to learn more and bring it back to us, but to be able to make connections with other music leaders that he then can have that opportunity of learning more in a community that's very focused on music as well. Andre.
For this particular fundraiser, I will do matching funds up to $600 to whatever anybody else.
Thank you. That donation can be made here, it can be made online. Just make sure that you signify where the donation is to go.
By when?
We need it by, we have 2 weeks, as I think.
The conference is February 22nd through the 27th.
But we need to get him an airfare. Miss Linda, you had something?
I wanted to mention Jamie Snyder.
Oh, thank you. Yes, that was my third that I couldn't remember on my list, Linda. Thank you. And that is that Jamie's mother passed this week. So that's why Scott is with her and family this weekend. And that her memorial will be Tuesday at midnight for those of you. I will be going out of this particular to that grave sign service. So for those who like to attend, we have the details for that.
So is this Pam's first time flying solo ever?
Second.
Excellent.
Yes, thank you. And Pam is winging and doing it all, even when she has troublemakers that don't turn the mics on. Thank you.
join us in our closing unity circle. So we'll circle up and join hands. And remember that Eleanor.